more arrests and more argy-bargy between police and protesters outside Parliament. Numerous scuffles punctuated a day of occupation of Parliament's lawn with a massive surge in the number of arrests, the remaining demonstrators now defying a trespass warning. Some tents have been removed from the lawn, but there are still flags and signs aplenty. As Kristen Hall reports, there are now divisions in the group about whether to protest peacefully or not.
Picked off one by one. Police stepped up their presence at Parliament again today. 120 people arrested today alone. So many, they had to be transported in this supersized truck.
We have moved now to a state of enforcement action.
Day three of the occupation of Parliament has seen more clashes between protesters and police and hundreds of unmasked people vowing to stick around. Despite orders to remove tents and the threat of arrest, protesters say they have enough energy and resources to stay for days, if not weeks.
I'm getting clean because a clean protester is a good protester.
Sausages, hundreds and hundreds of sausages. Sausages since 7 a.m.
This is the side of the protest many want the public to see. Free food donated and served by volunteers. Some are frustrated by those making threats against politicians and media and attacking police.
They tend to get the crowd very irritated and agitated. Then they start pushing and shoving.
Him up. Do you see him? He didn't come from our protest.
Sorry, I said maybe you could end up on trial. I doubt it.
Mayor Andy Foster came out to speak to businesses affected by the continued traffic blockade, but quickly found himself surrounded.
Where should we peacefully protest, Mayor of Wellington?
Well, I guess the question is how long you peacefully protest and what the impact is on other people. It feels intimidating, and I can see why a lot of people perhaps who are less used to that kind of environment or are going to feel, you know, very intimidated by that.
With the help of police, wardens began ticketing illegally parked vehicles still clogging the roads around Parliament.
You're stopping people's freedom!
You gonna pay it?
No.
A relief to small businesses starting to feel the pinch of empty streets.
We'd have five or six people in the shop all the time through from 12 till 2. There's no one here.
What's becoming clearer is how much people are willing to sacrifice for this cause.
I'm leaving my husband. He got the booster today. He's gone. I don't want anything to do with him. I seriously believe he's going to die. That's getting off topic.
And concern that passion will turn into something much more difficult to control.
A lot of these groups are inspired by the January 6th insurrection in the state. And I think there's a real risk that some of the people who believe this disinformation may be radicalised into violence.
With people willing to risk it all.
I will die for my grandchildren today.
Off, you f***ing idiots!
More confrontation could be on the cards.
And Kristen's with us now live. Kia ora, Kristen. The protesters have been there a while now. Give us an idea of the feeling down there.
Kia ora, Simon. They certainly have been, and those that haven't been arrested today look to be settling in for a third night. There are around 50 tents erected, even though several of them were taken away. Pretty much the same number as there were last night. Obviously, with those 120 arrests, the size of the crowd has been downscaled a little bit, but there are still several hundred people there. No argy-bargy at the moment. People are being fairly calm, and the police have downscaled their presence an awful lot since this afternoon, but no doubt there'll be reinforcements ready to come in if things do kick off again.
And we're seeing a range of groups being represented there. How's this being organised?
Well, it's not really being organised in a traditional sense, Simon. There is no single organiser or group of organisers for this protest, and that's something that some of the protesters I spoke to today say they'd like to see change. They've got internet messaging systems where people are messaging, hold the line, stand up against police, and at the same time, you've got different people on the loudspeakers going, stand back, sit down, don't cause any trouble. So there are certainly divisions within the group. There are several different factions, and it'll be interesting to see how some of that tension plays out over the next few days.
And in your report, you mentioned cars are now being ticketed. Why did the council move on that today?
That's right. Well, simply, I think Wellingtonians were getting fed up of it and getting sick of the council not taking action. We're in the third day now of businesses being closed, of transport routes being affected, and people simply don't like the idea of being blockaded from part of the central city, of part of their own city, when several of the protesters here, most of them, in fact, haven't come from this region. We saw several hundred parking tickets being given out today. Most people are saying they're just not going to pay them, so getting them to actually actually move from these main routes, well, that is going to be a very different challenge.
Tēnā koe, Kristen. Thank you very much for that.